I'll tell you what, this is a show that will live on forever, not just here on TV, but in the hearts and minds of, guys, I would be willing to say a million children who have now grown up, the Wallace and Ladmo Show, 35 years on Channel 5, and now, thanks for tuning in, the story of Bill Thompson, who obviously is Wallace. It's written by Richard Rayless from the Arizona Republic, and we have both of you here. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for having us down.
You know what? I will tell you what. You have already been swamped. That show's been off, what?
15 years.
15 years? And what happened when you walked in here?
A couple of people came up and said hi. A
couple of people? You got swamped. We had one girl back here wanting to cry because she saw her childhood friend Wallace.
Well, it made my day. I remember you. You were our last show.
I was.
And you had that camera and you put it right in my face and I was making faces. Oh, yeah. You were our last show in 89 as a reporter for...
Channel 3?
Yeah, video shooter. Yeah.
And you know what? That's the ironic thing, and I mentioned this earlier. We would never, ever go do a story at another TV station now. But when you guys taped your last show, we were there and I actually was live on your set for our 5 o'clock.
Yeah, I mean, this show just celebrated its 10th anniversary. It's not as if the other stations came down to congratulate you guys.
No, we didn't hear anything about it. Now, how did you get involved? Did you grow up with watching Wallace?
I grew up watching the show. He was my childhood idol, and I got to meet him doing a story for the Arizona State University campus newspaper, the State Press, which got me to do the first coffee table book on the show. And then I realized his personal story, had never been told. And he doesn't tell it to many people. What I'm finding with people reading the book and just talking to, as I research and talk to people he knew, he didn't share his childhood with many of his friends he had in Phoenix.
Well, he's too embarrassed.
And people back in Bronxville sort of knew he had a television show, but had no idea that it was of the immense historic proportions that it was. And it really is, for those who didn't grow up here, it would be as if you and Scott did this show in funny hats.
Well, only better.
But this show was a dominant show that people all over the state watched and loved, even when they got out of childhood. Adults had a huge following of the show.
Well, one of the things we find out in that book is that Wallace was a name that went back a long way in your life. Where did that come from?
It's just a name I made up. Wallace Sneed, when I would write comedy sketches in high school and college, or essays, humorous essays, I would write about a guy named Wallace. Of course, they were all related to things that really happened to me. But it was just a character I invented. So when I went to Channel 5 and asked if I could do the New Kids show, because nobody else wanted to do it, I said, I got a character in mind. I know what he says and looks like.
And you still had to work 3 jobs at one point to support your family while you were the big TV star?
Oh, yeah, I was driving trucks and all kinds of strange stuff. I was a bartender at Easy Deal Wilson's out of Mesa. Yeah.
I mean, this man sacrificed a lot. And, you know, one of the untold stories about this man is that he came from a sort of a nice background in New York.
Sort
of. Had this dream. Well, yeah, writing
a little above,
up and down.
Sort
of,
yeah.
And had this dream of being on television in Phoenix and making people laugh, and gave up that nice life to make us laugh.
Yeah, in 1954, if you're in television, there's no money, you know. You got to do other things.
Yeah, we're going backwards too, by the way, if you're curious.
$20 a show or something, you know. That was
really, they're telling me to wrap, but I got to talk about one thing in the book. I mean, there's a lot of funny stuff, a lot of interesting about you, but the one thing was, there was a little bit of a falling out with Ladmo when the show ended, because he didn't want it to end. But you did renew your friendship and got a nice hug before he passed away a couple years ago.
And it's all in the book. It was sad, but he was my buddy. He was like a brother to me, and I miss him to this day.
I'll tell you what, we all do.
Yeah.
We all do. There's Ladmo right there, and you know what? You will still run into people today who say, I wish I'd have gotten my Ladmo bag. Wallace, thank you so much. Bill Thompson.
Right, Dan.
Terrific pleasure. Richard, thanks for writing the book.
Thank you.
It is terrific. Read it, people. That's all I can tell you. It's a fascinating book, and it is truly a love affair with some people we grew up with.